going to talk to you about 5 top neighborhoods in Sacramento. And you're going to want to watch this whole video because the last couple of neighborhoods I'm going to get into, it's kind of like the insider scoop because a lot of buyers, I'd say most buyers who move to town have never even heard of these 2 areas. And I think they are absolutely fabulous. All right, let's jump into it. Hi, this is Jacqueline Gage with the Gage Group right here in Sacramento. And if this is your first time at my channel, welcome. This is Living in Sacramento, where we give you the full 411 on Sacramento and go over all the neighborhoods and what it's like to live here. So if that's something you're into, don't forget, subscribe right down below and tap that bell button so you're notified every time I do a new video. Just do it right now. Okay, so if you're thinking about a move to Sacramento, definitely we love to help people relocate. We know all about Sacramento. Don't hesitate and reach out, call, text, PM, DM, whatever you prefer. So our first neighborhood is going to be Land Park. Land Park is an amazing neighborhood, so charming, in fact, oozing with charm. Let's talk about where it's located first off. Land Park is about 10 minutes from downtown. It's just south of the 80 freeway. The streets are going to be, it's south of Broadway and between Broadway and Sutterville, and east and west, it's between the freeway as well as Freeport. So very centralized, and there you can also see the park on the map as well. So Land Park is one of Sacramento's signature neighborhoods, one of the oldest neighborhoods. A lot of the homes were built, you know, through the 1920s to 40s, and that's why they have so much charm. It's really like, I always refer to it as a storybook, because when you go through the neighborhoods, you have the canopied trees and the little like Hansel and Gretel houses, just out of a storybook, literally. And for someone who loves the older, you know, character neighborhoods, this would be a neighborhood I'd highly recommend for you. A lot of the architecture are going to be Tudor, craftsmen's, other bungalows, some Mediterranean, like Spanish colonial. So you have an array of different styles. The whole neighborhood revolves around the Land Park, William Land Park, which is like the hub of the neighborhood. And it is a huge park. There's actually a golf course in the park. So there's so much to do. And you have people running. There's lots of events going on in the park, especially in the summertime. It provides a big sense of community for people living there. Always a lot of activity. And if you're a golfer, I love Land Park to golf. It's a fun little 9-hole golf course, really easy breezy, even if you aren't a golfer. I mean, during COVID, everyone's been a golfer, but you should give it a try. And some of the places that are very iconic in Sacramento, like the Tower Theater, are in Land Park. And what's awesome about the Tower Theater is Art Deco architecture. They have independent movies, so very unique. When Lady Bird premiered, it was at the Tower Theater. That's a great spot you should check out. Also, the Tower Cafe right next to it. Great place to have brunch, lunch, a very old neighborhood spot. A lot of the businesses are gonna be, nothing is cookie cutter, very charming, individualized, long-standing businesses. You also have the Sacramento Zoo there. This one place that I love, if you like sweets, you got to check out Spinners. It's completely random, but it's in a gas station, which I was kind of hesitant the first time, but checking out the reviews on Google, they're amazing. You won't be disappointed. So Spinners, Cinnamon Rolls, and Land Park. Now I want to talk to you a little bit about home pricing. Home pricing in Land Park, the median home price is going to be $720,000. You can get about a 3-bedroom, 2-bath for that, probably around 1600 square feet, maybe a little more. But Land Park goes from, you know, there's prices much lower in the 500s, probably mid 500s to get a 2-bedroom, 1-bath. Anything lower than that, it's going to probably be a rehab. There's probably a couple 400 sales, but other than that, you're looking just the buy-in in Land Park is going to be around 550. And things go up as high as into the millions. The last year, the sale was $1.7 million was the highest. So you can have a beautiful home, quite a bit of square footage for $1.7 million, especially when you're coming from the Bay Area. It's spectacular. And just to give you an indication of the inventory, you know, in the past year, there's been 113 properties sold in Land Park. That's why it's so competitive right now. It's not that many properties for the amount of buyers looking. And values have gone up about 10% in Land Park over the past year. Also, the average price per square foot is $489. The average square feet for a home in Land Park is about 1,600 square feet. You're gonna find it's more dense there. The lots are smaller. They're gonna be like 0.10 to 0.16. You're gonna find no 0.20s in Land Park, but has a great sense of community. Back in the day, that's just how things were built, much tighter lot sizes. Overall, I mean, this is a spectacular neighborhood and the close proximity to everything people love. So definitely want to put on your list. All right, our second neighborhood is going to be Curtis Park, which is adjacent to Land Park. It's a definitely established neighborhood. Also, just like Land Park, very charming, very storybookish. It's one of the most popular neighborhoods because it's close to downtown, close proximity. Let's look at the map. So you can see Curtis Park is right next to Land Park, south of Broadway. It's between the 99 freeway and Freeport and ends at Sutterville Road. So just as Land Park, Curtis Park has a park, and you know, in those communities, the park is like the hub. It anchors the community. You can kind of see the energy and vibrancy of the area. There's always something going on. They have tennis courts, basketball courts, people running, hanging out, having a picnic. So it's a great place to hang out. The style here is very similar to Land Park. You have those craftsman style homes, Tudor, Spanish Revival. The homes were built in the same time as well, early 1900s. Up into the 40s for the most part. So if you want a project, a lot of these homes can be an ongoing project. Definitely an exciting thing, but a lot of upkeep. So let's talk about pricing. So as I mentioned, it's going to be a little less than Land Park. The median price point for a home is $640,000. So what you get for that is gonna be like a 2-bedroom, 1-bath, probably 1,200 square feet, may still need some updating. So prices have definitely risen. The high in Curtis Park is gonna be $1.3 million. That's a fully dialed, gorgeous home over 2,000 square feet. And then, you know, anything you find in the fives is probably going to be really tiny, or it would be a fixer. And the average price per square foot is gonna be $428. Now I wanna talk to you about some places in Curtis Park. Just as Land Park, there's a lot of local spots that people think of when they think of Curtis Park. One of them is the famous Gunther's Ice Cream, local spot that been there forever. You know, people line up out the door in the summertime. Definitely try the bonbons if you go. Also, Pangea is right across the street. It has a lot of local craft beer, always changing, kind of elevated bar food, really yummy, great local spot to have. And you know, a lot of people can walk to it from their house. There's also, for a great brunch spot, you'll wanna check out Cafe Dan Terrell's. They have a lovely patio area you can sit, and great for like breakfast brunch. So Curtis Park, just as Land Park, a lot of similar style, a little less expensive, close to downtown, very charming and storybookish. Our third top neighborhood is going to be East Sacramento. So this is one of the most desirable areas in Sacramento to live. People love it because it's so centralized, as well as it's very charming. It's another storybook neighborhood. Let's talk about the location first. So it's very central. It's between the 80 freeway and 65th Street, as well as the 50 freeway and Elvis. The neighborhoods that border it are going to be Midtown, and then to the south is going to be Elmhurst, and you have the Med Center. The architecture style is going to be very much like Land Park and Curtis Park because of the time that it was built, in the 20s to the 40s, some in the 50s, but you have a lot of Tudors, craftsmen, other style bungalows, Spanish style. So a lot of great architecture. East Sacramento is known for the Fab 40s, which is a area of town. It's the 40 streets. So it's between Folsom and Jay and from 40th to 47th. And this is where we have the fanciest houses in East Sacramento. They're on larger lots, very estate-like. One of my favorite streets in the Fab 40s is going to be 45th Street. I just love that street. I think the houses are the best. That's the street, little trivia fact, that Ronald Reagan lived on 45th when he was the governor. It's the white, kind of like ivory brick house. You know, there's a lot of stuff that goes on in this community, especially during the holidays. In the Fab 40s, you have the Christmas lights, you know, people tour around, they take, there's horses and wagons that come in, and it's a whole big thing. People love to do it during the holidays, is come check out all the lights in East Sacramento. Also, you have the 4th of July parade, all the communities out, big 4th of July parade in the Fab 40s. They also have a home tour once a year where you can see some of these gorgeous homes in the inside, and a local designer will kind of do some of the interior. So it's a really great thing that you should put on your to-do list. So there's always something going on in the Fab 40s. It has a great sense of community in East Sac in general. What I love about East Sac is that there are so many parks. One of my favorite parks, and probably most people's favorite park, is going to be McKinley Park. It's a huge park. They have all sorts of things. You have a whole community center there, a library, tennis courts, basketball courts. There's a lovely pond, the Rose Garden. There's a trail to run around the whole park. It's very charming. People hang out there. There's always something going on in the park. On Saturdays, they have free yoga in the park. So that's definitely something, if you're a yogi, you want to check out. And Pops in the Park is something they do in East Sac, at all the different East Sac parks, where you get to have music in the park in the summer, a really fun thing. So it's a great place to meet the locals and get the vibe of the neighborhood. All right, so let's talk about the home pricing in East Sacramento. So East Sac is one of the highest priced per square foot places to live in Sacramento. It's going to be higher than Land Park and Curtis Park. The median price point is going to be $737,000. With that, you could get a 3-2, probably 1,300 square feet fully done. So not a large home, but also the high in East Sac goes, you know, in the Fab 40s, the highest sale was $3.5 million. So that's a huge estate-like home, fully dialed in. And then, you know, you can buy into the neighborhood at in the 550 range, but that's gonna be probably a tiny fixer. And lastly, the price per square foot is gonna be $482. So East Sac is, higher than most neighborhoods, but you know, I think the main attraction there is because it has such a high walkability factor, as well as the charming neighborhoods. So people can walk, bike. You have the main thoroughfares, J Street, H Street, and Folsom. And on those, you have the local restaurants, local boutiques, things that are very easy to access from the residential neighborhood. And that creates a big sense of community, and you know, a lot of people know each other. All right, so some places to check out in East Sac that are kind of reflective of the area. I would say Cordy Brothers, it's one of the oldest grocery stores in town. They have great specialty items, great deli meat. We have a lot of dive bars in East Sac, like Chargan's and Toomey. Also, next to the dive bars is the Pasty Shack. If you never had a pasty or been there, it's amazing. They're like pastry with little things inside, like meat and vegetables. The Mexican one is the best. I think it's on Thursdays. So definitely some spots to check out. So Sear Oaks is going to be our fourth neighborhood. And this is one of those neighborhoods that I told you, when people come to town, they've never heard of this area. It's literally what I call over the bridge, because a lot of people never go over the bridge. And that bridge I'm referring to is the H Street Bridge. And that kind of gets you into the whole Arden area, which is not far from downtown at all. It's probably like 15 minutes from downtown, 20 minutes maybe at worst. And Sear Oaks is a lovely area. It's situated along the American River, and it goes between the American River Drive and Fair Oaks Boulevard, as well as Monroe and Watt Avenue. So very centralized, close to the freeway, totally different than the other neighborhoods I was talking about. Sear Oaks has that California ranch style home. A lot of the homes were built in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. It's a very established neighborhood, but you will get much bigger lots. If you want the whole California lifestyle with a pool, Sear Oaks is the place for you. And it's suburban, but it's more suburban, but it's not suburbia by any means. You know, a lot of the homes have a lot of character, just in a different way than the ESAC in the land park, but you know, they're not as old, so the maintenance factor is going to be not as much either. So that's one of the pluses. Plus, you know, when you look at price per square foot, I do think you get a little bit more bang for your buck there too, especially when it comes to the lot size. Also, if you like mid-century homes, a lot of mid-century homes are in Sear Oaks. I have another video on String, but String Brothers is the biggest mid-century builder in Sacramento. They're very well known, and a lot of those homes are in Sear Oaks. So that, along with the ranch, and that's a big trend right now. So a lot of people should know about this area. Okay, so let's talk about the home pricing in Sear Oaks. So in Sear Oaks, you can get a median home for $855,000. I was actually surprised when I did the comps on that, because you can get a great home for much less than that. Even at 700, I looked, and there was a really nice home that just sold on the market. So, but I always say everyone's good is different. So you can definitely buy in at 700, pretty nice home, 2,500 square feet, 855. That median is actually much more of a dialed home, probably a pool, a good size lot, probably 0.25, maybe 0.20, and goes up to a high of over 2 million. So a good range in Sear Oaks. But also, if you don't want to move a bunch, so like in ESAC, there is a lot more inventory. Sear Oaks has a lot less inventory. Because when I think about this, ESAC, people usually get their first starter home and then they end up moving up. Sear Oaks, if you can get into the neighborhood, the homes are already really large. And so most people just will update it when they get more money. Or you can get a really nice home that's fully done. Just depends on what your needs are. But this is a great neighborhood. People love this neighborhood who want to be close to the river, who have that active lifestyle. There's going to be a little less homeless in this neighborhood, as opposed to anything. The closer you are to the city, the more homeless there are, which I've mentioned in my other videos, definitely an issue in Sacramento. It's a great family neighborhood, a lot of families, a lot of older people too in Sear Oaks, who've been living there forever. Sear Oaks is a great neighborhood for someone who loves to be by the river, you know, a biker or a runner, wants to lead an active lifestyle. You have all that right by the river. You also have the levee you can walk on. Sear Oaks is not as walkable as ESAC at all. You definitely have to get in your car, but it's like 5 minutes away. The shopping centers you'd be going to would be like Lohman's Plaza, really nice shopping center, has a lot of stuff in it. And has character, isn't like those stucco cookie cutter shopping plazas. Also, there's the Pavilions, which is, I would say, the premier shopping center in Sacramento. Lovely area, great restaurants to check out. We have Piatti's in there and Wildwood. Wildwood has a great patio if you want to go, you know, sit out, have a glass of wine. Really nice area. But Sear Oaks is a great place, very central, and kind of an unknown place for a lot of people when they move to Sacramento. So put it on your list. Last top neighborhood is going to be Arden Park. Just like Sear Oaks, is another neighborhood that a lot of people moving to town don't know about. So I wanted to put it on the list because it's fabulous, as I said in the beginning. Arden Park is a little different from Sear Oaks, a little more east and not as close to the river, but still close to the river. The location, we're gonna check out the map here. It's right off the freeway. It's between Watt Avenue and Eastern, and north is gonna be Arden, and to the south is gonna be Fair Oaks Boulevard, which is a main drag. So that area is very central. It's about probably 20, 25 minutes to downtown, depending on traffic. I'm not gonna lie, that area, Watt Avenue, can be a little bit of a disaster, but once you pull off of Fair Oaks Boulevard, and you can take Fair Oaks Boulevard all the way downtown, straight shoot if you don't want to get on the freeway. But Fair Oaks is a busy street, but once you pull off of Fair Oaks Boulevard into Arden Park, it's very quiet and tranquil. So you kind of have the best of both. You are, you know, in a central location, but once you pull off of the street, it's it's very calm and zen-like. And then those are the California ranch style homes. So if you like that style, this could be a great spot for you. Also, it's gonna be different than Sear Oaks. That is gonna have even bigger lots. So you definitely can have a pool in Arden Park and has a definite country vibe. Arden Park is actually what we consider in the county. So there are no sidewalks there. So it kind of gives that laid back country feel. But people walk around, it's very family oriented. It's surrounded by a park. There is an actual Arden Park. Also, a lot of the homes built in Arden Park are going to be in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, just like Sear Oaks. So older, definitely have character, but not 2040s old, which is a whole different kind of old. So a big benefit of Arden Park too is you're not far from the river, not as close to Sear Oaks, but still bikeable to the river. So if you're a river rat, could be a place for you. Also, Arden Park is centered around a park. So the park has a lot of great activities, has a community center, has a swimming pool, tennis court, basketball court, great swim team, Arden Park Dolphins. So great for the kiddos. And they have a lot of summertime events, movies in the park and so forth. Arden Park is a great place. I can't say enough good things about it. All right, so the home pricing in Arden Park, it's actually gonna be a little less than Sear Oaks. And I'm comparing it to Sear Oaks because a lot of buyers who are looking in Arden Park also look in Sear Oaks because it's the same style, close proximity. $750,000 is going to be the median. The high though is going to be up over $2 million. So you can have some really baller houses in Arden Park. The low is going to be around $550,000. It's not going to be dialed in, but you could get in the neighborhood and you could fix it up. And there you go. You have great appreciation. The average price per square foot is going to be $278,000. Last year, there was about 81 homes sold in Arden Park. So a fair amount of inventory. That $750,000 median home is going to be like a 3.2, at least 25 square feet on a lot that's probably 0.20 at least. The lots in Arden Park are a lot larger. They go all the way up, you know, some can be like even almost a full acre, but 0.25 to half acre is definitely not unheard of. So if you want the country life, maybe put some chickens in the backyard and a pool, Arden Park would be the spot. All right, guys. So don't forget, subscribe right down below. And if you watch this whole video, I have videos on all of these places on my channel. So check them out. And I'm going to be doing more, giving more of an in-depth analysis. But these are all great neighborhoods, top neighborhoods in Sacramento. Definitely kind of giving you a diverse range as far as style. And hope this has been informative. If you have any questions, let me know. And if you are considering a move to Sacramento, don't hesitate, reach out. We'd love to help you. All right, take care.